There is no mystery about who supplies the power for the number one Andrean 59ers. Mr. Basketball candidate Shane Power. Clint Swan's 24-2 59ers survived the semi-state for the first time in three straight tries. Andrean slipped past Pendleton Heights to strike gold in the north. Coach Leo Clem's Brebeuf Braves made it back to the title game for the first time since the days of Alan Henderson in the early 90s. Brebeuf survived a thrilling 66-63 win over Evansville Modern Day in the Washington semi-state on a three-pointer at the buzzer by senior guard Jon Owens. The number three Braves also get offensive punch from Mike Bennett. Who will replace Plainfield as the 3A champion? School Athletic Association proudly presents the 2000 Boys Basketball State Championships.
Two down and two to go. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to Conseco Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis. Jerry Baker along with Dave Nicholson. Dave, we've crowned the A and the 2A winners. We had a terrific afternoon of basketball. I expect more of the same tonight.
Only better. It'll get better every step of the way. We've got two teams here right now in 3A. They've lost a total of four games in the 4A. Only one loss among the two teams. It's going to be a great evening. If folks out there love basketball, they're going to love tonight.
And two great candidates for Mr. Basketball will be on the floor also tonight.
Absolutely.
All right, Bob Nagel will join us shortly, and the St. Vincent's Hospital pregame show is coming up next.
The IHSAA Boys State Championship pregame show is brought to you by St. Vincent Sports Medicine, the spirit of caring. Call 338-CARE.
Two teams with a combined loss record of 4. Two losses for Brebeuf, two for Andrean. This should be a terrific battle for the Class 3A championship game. And Dave, let's take a look now with the key players for the Brebeuf Braves tonight.
Okay, for Brebeuf, you have to start with number 32, Michael Bennett, a 6'5 senior, 17 points a game. The other person we have to take a look at is number 12, Jon Owens, a 6-foot senior. He also averages 17 points a game for Brebeuf. The keys to the game for Brebeuf tonight, they're going to have to keep track of Power, of course, and Staten. Power is the key at 26, but don't forget about Staten coming in at 17 points. They got to play their tempo, which is a half court. They got to continue the strong board play they've had all year. Let's hear from the coach of the Brebeuf Braves, Leo Clem.
What do you know about the 59ers, and what can folks expect out of your team?
Well, we know the 59ers are a good basketball team. We've seen them on tape. We'll be well prepared. Our team will continue the same things they've done, and that is to play very good defense, execute offensively, and just play an overall good basketball game.
Now, Dave, let's check the keys to the game for the Andrean ball club tonight, or the key players for the game.
Yeah, player everybody's going to look for tonight is number 20, Shane Power. He's averaging 26 points a game, and number 21, Nathaniel Staten, 17 points a game. The keys to the game for Andrean, their transition game, they love to run. They got to get it going. They got to out-rebound Brebeuf, and they've got to find Michael Bennett and keep track of him. And now a word from Clint Swan, the coach at Andrean.
Congratulations on being here in the state championships. I know it's an exciting time and a lot of things to think about, but just being here has got to be special.
Yes, it is. We're all very happy to be here. After losing the semi-state 2 years in a row, third time was a charm for us, and we're all real excited.
And now it's time to meet the teams for the 3A championship. Brebeuf and Andrean, let's go across the floor now and say hello to Scott Gregg.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis and Conseco Fieldhouse for the Class 3A State Championship game of the 90th Indiana High School Athletic Association State Basketball Tournament, the greatest tournament in the land. Our game tonight features the Brebeuf Jesuit Braves and the Andrean Fighting 59ers. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for tonight's game. First for the Brebeuf Jesuit Braves. Number 10, Matt Comperano. Number 11, Blake Ertl. Number 24, Sonny Trotman. Number 35, Ben Pitts. Number 40, James Martin. Number 45, Kevin McCammack. And the starting lineup for the Braves, at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 12, Jon Owens. At guard, a 5-foot 11-inch senior, number 20, Jarvis Joyner. At forward, a 6-foot 4-inch sophomore, number 22, Marcus Bennett. At forward, a 6-foot 6-inch junior, number 33, Evan Beadle. And the center, a 6-foot 5-inch junior, number 32, Michael Bennett. Head coach of the 23-2 Braves, Leo Clem. And now your roster and starting lineup for the Andrean Fighting 59ers. Number 10, Matt Jensen. Number 14, Andy Gernak. Number 24, Josh Fry. Number 31, Robbie Gard. Number 40, Kevin Brown. Number 43, Ryan Barbald. And the starting lineup for the 59ers, at guard, a 6-foot 2-inch senior, number 21, Nathaniel Staten. At guard, a 6-foot junior, number 42, Rashad Pace. At forward, a 6-foot 5-inch senior, number 20, Shane Power. At forward, a 6-foot 2-inch junior, number 44, Justin Castellanos. And the center, a 6-foot 2-inch junior, number 32, Elliot Borden. Head coach of the 59ers, Clint Swan.
So there you have the starting lineups for Brebeuf and Andrean. We'll be back with the tip-off for the Class 3 state championship game in just a moment here on the LaCie Broadcasting IHSAA Television Network.
The pregame show has been brought to you by St. Vincent Sports Medicine, the spirit of caring. Call 338-CARE.
The Brebeuf Braves at 23-2, coached by head coach Leo Clem, and the Andrean Fighting 59ers at 25-2. In fact, the eight team finalists we had here, Dave, you combine their record, 191 wins, 21 losses, a winning percentage of 90%. That might tell you why they were at the state finals today.
That's one reason they're here, and it's also a sign it's going to be high-quality basketball, as it has been all day and will be in this game.
Last 3A championship game is underway. Brebeuf will get the opening tip and set it up to the goal to our left. That's the northern goal here at beautiful Conseco Fieldhouse. Let's check these Brebeuf Braves out. They average over 66 points a game. They missed the first attempt. And Brian averages 76 points a game. So they do like to get it up and down the court. And the two games we saw earlier today, the A and the double A, it was like they were on fast forward the whole doggone game.
Both of those games really exploded.
Long shot off the mark, no good by Andrean. Shane Power. And the ball knocked away. Now, they listed Power in the starting lineup as a forward. Basically, it's a four-guard lineup or a three-guard lineup for Andrean.
Sure, and the first time up, you saw where Shane Power was. He's out the top of the key playing point guard. He's a perimeter player, but he can play anywhere.
He's their tallest guy at 6'5", but nonetheless, still basically is a guard. They also they listed as a forward Justin Castellanos, and their head Rashad Pace. Basically, they got five good players is what it comes down to. You can't put them in a particular category because they'll play all over the floor, as Dave Nicholson just suggested. Wide open look on the near side by Bennett. Does not take the shot. Brebeuf patient. They will not give you very many points. There's the first turnover of the game. Brebeuf allows only 51.4 per game, and Andrean 57.7. So we got the immovable object and the irresistible force, because you got good offense facing good defense at both ends of the floor.
And you just saw Jon Owens throw the ball away. That's a rarity. Brebeuf takes care of the basketball.
And Andrean with the basketball for the second time. Gets inside. A wild shot is off the mark. And Jon Owens picks up the loose ball. They'll bring it back the other way with Marcus Bennett in charge. Set up the offense. Wide open look on the right side. Jarvis Joyner.
Talked about power playing outside. You see where Michael Bennett is right there. He's listed as center. He played guard up until this year.
There's the first couple of points. Michael Bennett. Bennett getting the first 2 points. And Brebeuf will take the lead.
Headed to Ball State next year, Michael Bennett. He'll play two guard up there, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's one of the keys to the success that Leo Clem has had. Natural position is guard for Bennett, but they needed him up front. They shifted him around. Here's the traveling violation. First turnover at the other end for Andrean.
It'll take a couple minutes for each of them to settle down. They've got to be really hyped because everyone sees this as kind of the unknown game, but a very even game.
Now, Dave and I were talking before the game began. I said, I don't have a feel for this game. It's difficult to say, not that it won't be a great game, but you just couldn't get a feel for how the game was going to shake out.
Well, you know there's going to be some great individual plays made.
There's one of them right there. It's Jarvis Joyner off balance and double clutching, and it's a 4-0 ball game now with Brebeuf on top.
Coach Clem's philosophy is guard from the basket out, which means they help side really well inside, do the best you can on the outside.
There's a steal for the pass by Michael Bennett. Got it up court. There's the miss layup that time, but Marcus Bennett will go the other way in a hurry.
He's on the wrong foot.
And a wide open player down to the baseline area. Couldn't get it there. Here's the block shot off the attempt. Here's the put back up and good. That's Shane Power getting his first 2 points on this ball game. Power comes in averaging 26-3 in 24 of the 26 games for Andrean. 5.5 minutes to go, and that's the first time that Andrean's been on the scoreboard tonight.
So watch all these games today, Jerry. You can tell where the weight program comes into effect as you saw Michael Bennett make a strong move to the basket and put it down.
Yeah, you know, there used to be, Dave, back maybe even when you were coaching, you used to let those weights alone, but not anymore.
Early on, about 15, 20 years ago, they started the weight training, and you can sort of see it on all these.
Absolutely. Yeah. Here's a wild shot. It's a good defensive effort. It's put on by Brebeuf. Motor out butt is off the mark by Shane Power. Rebound comes off to Brebeuf. They average just a shade over 29 rebounds a game. Baseline move, put up off the mark, an air ball, but right there, to Johnny on the spot. It. Marcus Bennett gets his first 2 points of the game. We go to an 8-2, 6-point lead for Brebeuf. Now, that's their biggest lead so far.
Brebeuf seems a little quicker to attack than Andrean does.
There's a nice bank shot off the left wing by Rashad Pace. He is a junior, a six-footer, averaging 9.8 points per game. And again, not to be redundant, but just like this afternoon, bring it up, set it up, let it rip. There is no fear on the part of any of these clubs in this championship round.
One thing's been missing today, none of these teams have had a really strong post player.
That's a good point.
The best from Lafayette Catholic did a nice job of posting up, but he's truly a wing player.
Outside shots off the mark, inside rebound, taken down by Nathaniel Staten. He'll bring it back up in a hurry. Halfway through the first quarter, 8-4 is your score. Brebeuf is on top, and a whistle and a foul, a blocking foul called against Brebeuf. And the foul is on number 12. That'll be Jon Owens, so that'll be his first of the game. Timeout has been taken, 3:52 to go, 8-4 Brebeuf leads Andrean.
Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse. A reminder that there is a Burger King near Brebeuf High School at 86th and Michigan Road. Burger King before and after the game.
Been there many a time, Bob, and I highly recommend it. You would like it.
They'll be open after the game tonight.
Then we'll go up and get a burger
there
or two.
There you go.
The stats show a little bit of why Brebeuf is ahead 8-4. Andrean is 2-for-9, 22%. And Brebeuf 4-of-8, 50%.
And Andrean shoots 55% on the season, and Brebeuf 51%. Two really good shooting ball clubs. Long range three is off the mark, and the rebound taken down by Brebeuf's number 33, Evan Beadle, a 6'6 junior.
Brebeuf's doing a great job on the board. It's pretty much one and out for Andrean to this point.
Go ahead, a wide open look in the right corner down there to Jarvis Joyner. Couldn't find him, couldn't get it there. 3:20 to go in the first quarter of this game. Oh, what a baseline move.
Michael Bennett.
Bennett looking strong at the baseline. Has scored 3 buckets, 6 of the 10 points on the board. And back to the 6-point lead for Brebeuf. Ball in the middle, knocked away, and last touch by Brebeuf. And we'll get a substitution, the first of the evening, coming in for Andrean, number 14, Andy Gernak, a 5'9 junior who comes off the bench, but indeed leads the club in assists with 71.
Last time down, Andrean went to a zone because Brebeuf had been breaking them down with the dribble.
Andrean basketball. Andrean in the red and gold. Those are school colors. Brebeuf in the maroon and gold.
Here's a 2-3 zone by Brebeuf.
There's the skip pass across the top and another block shot. Terrific effort that time with a guy who's got the basketball. That is Michael Bennett. Comes over on the near side and Jarvis Joyner has his second field goal. Make it a 12-4 ball game. An 8-point lead for Brebeuf, their biggest. Not that it means anything, but in both the afternoon games, the first club that scored never trailed the rest of the game. There were only a couple of ties all afternoon. And the team that scored first won the ball game. Here's a baseline violation for Andrean. And Brebeuf will get it back.
No room down there but power. You're exactly right. So far the game, every game today, there's been a team jump out to a huge lead. And here's Brebeuf up 8 here early in the game. So we'll see if that holds true to form. But you could say the afternoon games pretty much were decided in the first 4 minutes.
Exactly. In fact, there was not a single lead change in either of the afternoon games. Final score in that NCAA, Wisconsin has defeated Purdue 64-60. And Wisconsin goes to the Final Four. Long range shot from outside, and I mean way outside. That's Jon Owens, who has 43 threes coming into the game tonight. His first contributions offensively tonight gives Brebeuf a 15-4 lead.
Jon Owens shoots 47% behind the arc.
Well, we talked about that in the afternoon games, Dave Nicholson, about how many good shooting outside clubs there are.
Well, I think when they drew that line around there about 4, 5, 6 years ago, all the kids now in the offseason, they don't practice on their one-on-one. They go behind the line, see how many threes they can shoot.
And that's part of that development program, that physical development you talked about. That is on Michael Bennett. Here's the replay again.
You saw the replay there, and Bennett came down just in an awkward position.
Bob?
A remarkable feature in life. That's what Marion College offers. Call Marion College toll free at 1-800-772-7264 or visit their website at www.marion.edu to learn how you can begin your remarkable future at Marion College.
Rashad Pace missing and the rebound coming off to Brebeuf. Neither club getting a lot of offensive boards. Here's the steal. They read the passing lane and right down the lane to Shane Collins. A power slam for Shane Collins.
Here's a full court 1-2-1-1 diamond one press. Just got a steal and a bucket by Powers for Andrean.
A minute 20, almost another steal directly in front of us here. And Brebeuf now settling things down a little bit. Matt Camperato is in the lineup now, the 5'9 sophomore for the Brebeuf Braves.
Jon Owens tried a three and airballed it from the left wing.
A minute 5 to go in the first quarter of this game for the 3A championship in Indiana high school basketball. Whistle and a foul. The referees are Bob Anderson. He'll make the call. Bob's from Indianapolis. And Steve Kovachkov from Crown Point. The foul is on Matt Camperato. That's the first of the ball game on him. Brebeuf will make a change. And Marcus Bennett will come back into the ball game, replacing Evan Beadle.
Andrean has kind of taken a page out of Brebeuf's book the last two times they've used the dribble, the penetration. That's what Brebeuf is doing so well at the other end. The last two times they've put the ball down on the dribble as well.
There's the alley-oop pass, not particularly effective, but Powell went and got it anyway and scores. Shane with his 6 point.
Doesn't take long to see that Shane Power has the tools.
No, it does not. Andrean fighting 59ers, hustling back defensively as they are down 15-9. Andrean located, by the way, in Merrillville, Indiana. So it's the north versus the semi-south, I guess, with Brebeuf being on the north side of Indianapolis.
You're going to see Brebeuf hold for one shot unless they get a wide open look here with about 25 seconds to go. They'll just move the ball around. They'll make their move, try to get the shot at 4 seconds. That prevents Andrean from going the other way.
Eddie Trotman is in the ballgame for Brebeuf. He had the ball momentarily. Now he'll sneak down to the to our left. And we're going to wait now. Now we're inside 10 seconds.
Keep an eye on 32.
Here's the baseline jumper. He got it. Good looking shot by Jon Owens. 5 points for Jon. And they got it back, put it up, and almost hit it. Sonny Trotman made the intercept and darn near got it to fall. After one, it is 17 for Brebeuf, 9 for Andrean. for the Class AAA Championship here on the C Sports IHSAA Television Network.
The IHSAA Boys State Basketball Championships are brought to you in part by Methodist Sports Medicine Center. We keep you in the game. And by Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
All right, welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis. We have completed one quarter play for the 3A title, and it's 17-9 with Brebeuf on top.
Andrean's having trouble finding the basket in that first quarter. They're 4 of 11 from the field for 36%, whereas Brebeuf is shooting extremely well, 8 of 14 for 57%.
Top scorer for Brebeuf, Michael Bennett with 6. Jon Owens had 5. Andrean had only 2 players score. Shane Power with 6. And Rashad Pace added 3. Second quarter underway. 3A title is on the line. We've already crowned the A, Lafayette Central Catholic. And Westview won the AA title. Down inside, little baseline. The shot is up and good by Marcus Bennett. Andrean tried to draw the foul, couldn't get it done, and now it's a 19-9 ball game in favor of Brebeuf.
We'll give Sonny Troutman credit. He stepped in and stole it, went down and dropped it off to Michael Bennett.
Well, some real strong defensive play out there in both ends of the court that time by Jon Owens. Jon broke up the offensive set and then tried to sneak across and steal the ball on the other side. He is forcing Andrean to take some cross-court skip passes that I'm not sure they really want to do, but they don't have any options right now.
Andrean's going to have to get Nathaniel Staten in the ballgame. He averages 17 points a game. He hasn't gotten any looks yet.
Here's Power. He had it knocked away and caught it. Going down the lane. The official right there on top of it. Saw no violation. Shane now with 8 at the other end. It's Sonny Troutman. Up and down basketball, much like what we have seen in the previous two games today. 21-11, 10-point lead for Brebeuf. They've led by as many as 11. No ties. They have never trailed in this game. Well, that defensive, that work out front by Jon Owens is really strong. Here's the ball in the baseline. Nice save by Sonny Troutman, who's come off the bench for head coach Leo Clem, who's in his second year at Brebeuf, a record of 35-12, winning percentage of 74.5%. Brebeuf 23-2. Losses at Greenfield Central 63-60 in the second game of the year, and then to Perry Meridian 68-64 in overtime on the 11th of January. The last time they lost a game. Couple of minutes into the second quarter. 21-11 in favor of Brebeuf. Sliding down the lane. The ball is off the mark and stolen out of there. Excellent defensive play by Michael Bennett. Gets it back up court. The floater won't go. Rebound Shane Power. Andrean at 24-2. They lost 2 of their first 5 games when Shane Power was injured and not able to go, and that really impacted the club. Once he got back and got healthy, it turned everything around.
Mm-hmm. Shane Power had a back injury. He took some pain medicine for it, and the medicine upset his stomach to the point he had an ulcer. And he had to end up in the Mayo Clinic for a couple of days and got straightened out. And what a privilege it is to see him play. I've heard about him all year, and I was looking forward to this.
And good to see him healthy also.
Mm-hmm. He looks great.
Nice ball movement by Andrean. He'll get the baseline shot. No good. Put back up and good, though, by Andrean's Elliot Gordon. And Elliot's in the scorebook for the first time. We're going to get a timeout now. A 20-second timeout. 20-second timeout. You got something for us, Bob?
Absolutely, Jerry. It's March Mania at Bob Roarman Indy Honda. Bob Roarman slam dunks the competition with unbelievable prices. Bob Roarman will meet or beat any price, or they'll give you $500 in cash. That's Bob Roarman Indy Honda.
While we have a second, Bill McDonald is a physics teacher at Brebeuf Jesuit. He got married in the chapel at the school this morning at 11:30. And he and his new bride are at the game tonight following their wedding and the reception. Bill is the girls softball and boys wrestling team coach, married Jen Alexander. Now, that is a marriage that's going to last a long time if you can get her to come to a basketball game on your wedding day.
And that's a commitment to the Brebeuf Braves.
That is truly a commitment, my friend. My thanks to the folks who, to Bev Gallagher, Director of Public Relations, who faxed that over to him. It's a great story. Offensive rebound, one of the few, and Sonny Troutman, who's come off the bench and played well, has scored by 4 points in this game.
He averages 7 on the year, and he came in and has given his team a big lift.
The
It's 23-13 in favor of Brebeuf with 4 minutes and 35 seconds to go here in the opening half. Here's the quick pass up court. They got it to Marcus Bennett. He'll go all the way in and get the layup. And I believe Andrean wants the timeout because right now Brebeuf owns this ballgame. It's a 20-second timeout. This reminds me a little bit of the way that Brody Boyd was handled, where he was releasing in those kinds of situations. Bob?
Would you like to make your printed materials more effective, increase readership, retention, and response by 75 to 85%? You can do it by adding color to your printing from PIP Printing. PIP does color in a big way, adding big impact and more bang for your printing buck. So if you want it in color, on time, take it to PIP.
Let's take a look at this again, and you'll watch the release. They get up court in a hurry.
That's Marcus Bennett's releasing, but they've done that several times. Marcus Bennett has done it. Michael Bennett's done it. I think that's a part of their offense. The outside player, as soon as they see the shot goes up, the inside player seal off the rebound, they release a player.
Yeah, my reference was to Brody Boyd of Union Governor, who had a terrible time getting started. And once he did, they just sent him out. Great defensive play again by Bennett. And a steal at the other end by Andrean. And a quick personal foul called on Marcus Bennett right in front of us here.
Marcus got his shirt pretty good, and he turns around and said, me?
What, me?
But it was pretty evident. It was right in front of us. We don't keep deflections, but it's amazing how many times Brebeuf has been able to deflect Andrean's passes. Andrean's going to have to put in the ball fake. If you don't ball fake, you're probably going to get your pass interfered with a deflection or a steal.
Andy Gurnah going out of the lineup for Andrean, and 6'1 junior Josh Fry, who does not score much, average only a half a point a game, comes into the lineup now for the Andrean Fighting 59ers. We are halfway through this second quarter, and another defensive effort that turns into a steal. Here's the outlet pass again. It's Michael Bennett. Well, they are really doing a terrific job, as you suggest, Dave Nicholson. Seal off the inside and turn somebody north.
And it's usually one of the Bennett brothers.
That's a 14-point lead now, and that's the biggest lead of the ball game for Brebeuf.
Well, if you're Coach Swan of Andrean, there's not much else to do. He's taken two timeouts. You hate to waste all your timeouts, but again, you can't let the ball game get out of hand either.
Here's a quick pull-up three from long range by LaSaniel Staten. That'll turn it around just a bit. Staten, the good outside shooter, had 42 three-point field goals made coming into tonight's game.
Shoots 45% from the three line, and they've been waiting for him to show up.
Here's a nice block. That's power with the defensive play. Behind the back dribble by Staten again. Takes it all the way in. Got in too deep. That'll go the other way. Here's the free shot. It is up and it is good. And that is the bucket by Sonny Trotman. I keep calling his name, and why not? He's played really well off the bench for Brebeuf.
He's really come in and given the offense a boost with three field goals all here in the second quarter.
Jay Powers, spin move inside. Good body control. Now they come outside, long range, and there's the foul right at the timeline on Rashad Pace. That's number one on him. And right now, Brebeuf is physically beating Andrean at both ends of the floor.
It's all about emotion and quickness. Brebeuf is really putting energy into their defense and just making turnovers on Andrean.
And a timeout with 2:50 to go. It's 29-16. Brebeuf leads Andrean on the IHSAA television network. Along with Bob Nagel and Dave Nicholson, welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse. It's 29-16 in favor of Brebeuf. Bob?
Stevens Mortuary offers pre-need and at-need services. Stevens Mortuary is located at 5520 West 10th Street in Indianapolis. Stevens Mortuary, proud sponsor of Indiana High School basketball tonight.
All right, substitution in the lineup now for Brebeuf. Matt Comparato has come back into the lineup. Jon Owens with the basketball. Inside 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Brebeuf's been extremely dominant in this game. They're getting a lot of push shots, just like that one right there from Marcus Bennett. Well, he has six, and Sonny Trotman has six this quarter.
Jerry, I think it's imperative that Andrean make a little move here in the next 2.5 minutes before halftime. They trail by 15. If not, they're in trouble.
This is, you said it earlier, Dave Nicholson, this is a replay of both of the afternoon games. When one team came out, dominated early, and in both those instances, the other team came back and made a game out of it. But here's a long-range shot, the three by Shane Power, and Power has 11 points now. He has 38 threes now on the year, counting that one right there.
Iowa State's going to love that kid.
Oh, boy. Baseline shot put up, partially deflected, comes down into the hands of Andrean's Rashad Pace. Shane Power, as we mentioned, will head for Iowa State. They're one of the teams still alive in that NCAA tournament. inside a couple of minutes now. Power again from outside, this time nothing doing, and a terrific job of keeping the ball alive by Jon Owens. Power gets it, goes inside, and draws the foul.
What a tremendous move there by Shane Power to get in the position to get that offensive rebound and get to the free throw line. The key players find a way. Now he's got a chance. It doesn't sound like 10 points is a big lead, but they're down 12. If he can knock these in, you're going to see a replay here after the first shot. I want the folks at home to watch Shane Power's move, but what I was saying, he's got a chance to cut this lead to 10. That's not bad. If they can get into halftime 10 or less, the way the half's gone, I think Andrean will be pretty happy with that. Here's your replay. Now watch Shane Power just come down the middle, split the defender, spin move, and almost throws the ball in the basket.
The personal foul, by the way, was on Matt Comparato. That was his second. Shane Power's an excellent free throw shooter. He hits 80% from the line. That was his first attempt. In fact, only the third for Andrean in this game. He gets one out of the two, and he has scored a dozen points, six in the first, six here in the second quarter of play. And that makes it an 11-point ball game, a 31-20 in favor of Brebeuf. Near steal inside, but Brebeuf manages to maintain control of the basketball. They've got some good athletes on this club.
Great athletes. I think if Andrean can get a stop here and get one more bucket, they'd feel pretty good about the halftime after the way things were going, because it'll be in single digit. Otherwise, if Brebeuf holds it here as they are and gets the final shot, that's kind of demoralizing, because then it goes to either 12 or 13 point deficit. There's a big difference where you're in single digits or double digits.
Brebeuf now has the basketball, and the clock has run to exactly 1 minute right now.
Last time this happened, they gave it to Jon Owens, number 12. He went along the baseline for a jump shot. I think it'll be Owens or it'll be Michael Bennett that makes the final play.
That is Owens with the basketball right there. Now Jarvis Joyner back to Owens. On the near side, they come to Marcus Bennett. Clock shows 45 seconds to go in the first half. Andrean defensively just letting Brebeuf do what they will. And with no shot clock in high school basketball, they can eat up a lot of time here.
They're going to use it all the next 30 seconds and take one unless Andrean forces a turnover or commits a foul.
One thing I've noticed here, Dave, Andrean has pushed him out further defensively. They had him out probably further than they really wanted to be. They're out almost to the timeline.
They're going to spread the court pretty wide until it gets down to about 10 seconds, and then they'll go into whatever their last end of game, end of quarter shot is, and every team has one or two options.
Joyner got it down to Troutman, down in the corner, almost double team, comes back outside. Joyner lost the basketball. It is saved, though, by Bennett. Bennett will come off in the corner. Here's the open look by Owens, and he got it.
Same thing that happened in the first quarter, if you remember. We just talked about Jon Owens.
He did it from the other side. That's the only difference. Manley milked that thing for a minute and a half, and it worked beautifully. At halftime, the Brebeuf and Andrean battle for the 3A title has been all Brebeuf. They have led by as many as 15. They'll go to the locker room up by 13. At halftime, Brebeuf 33 and Andrean 20 for the 3A title. We have some interesting festivities coming up at halftime when we'll come back and you'll get a chance to take a look at them. Let's go over to Bob. Bob, you got the coach, I see.
Clint Swann is with us, and Clint, a tough first half. They got off to a great start against you. A lot of transition baskets for your opponent tonight.
Yeah, it's mainly just starting out taking care of the basketball. They're getting deflections and getting steals and getting to the other end before we can get back. We got to do a better job of taking care of the basketball just by being strong with it.
Team's going to overplay you like that on defense. Is there a chance that you make that adjustment and take advantage of it?
We need to do what we can to somehow relieve that pressure by using back cuts, setting back screens, more screens on the ball, and things of that nature.
Took you guys a little while to get going, but offensively you're going pretty well right now.
Not like we'd like. You know, we've got to, until we eliminate these turnovers, we're not going to have much success scoring, that's for sure.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. All right, Clint Swann, the head coach of the 59ers, some work to do in the second half. Let's take a break. We'll be back at Conseco Fieldhouse in a moment. You're watching the IHSAA State Championships on the LaCie Broadcasting Network.
The IHSA Boys State Basketball Finals are brought to you in part by St. Vincent Sports Medicine, the spirit of caring. Call 338-CARE.
A nighttime outdoor look at beautiful Conseco Fieldhouse. Now back inside. We're at halftime. It's 33-20 in favor of Brebeuf. Let's go across the floor now to our PA announcer, Scott Gregg.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to honor the young Indiana athletes who have won the IHSAA Mental Attitude Award so far this year. As the proud corporate partner of the IHSAA, Farm Bureau Insurance awards a $1,000 scholarship to each school attended by a Mental Attitude Award winner. during the 1999-2000 school year, Farm Bureau Insurance will award $38,000 to Indiana high schools through this worthy program. Congratulating the winners at center court is Mr. Robert Gardner, IHSAA Commissioner, and Teresa Koopman, Director of Advertising and Marketing for Farm Bureau Insurance. Now let's meet the mental attitude of winners. In football, Jeremy Chandler, Ben Davis High School. J.D. Lane, Danville High School. Zachary Wagner, Perry Central. And Nicholas Warden, Norwell. In golf, Leanne Harden, Martinsville. In cross country, Lisa Nicholson, Anderson Highland. And Brian Dunn, Franklin Central. From swimming, Brooke Taflinger, Kokomo. And Alec Sheehy, Columbus North. In soccer, Elizabeth Custer, Indianapolis North Central. And Matthew Abbott, Penn High School. In girls basketball, Lisa Hopinions, Forest Park. Sarah Strom, Ben Davis. And Kathleen Stroop, Columbia City. In gymnastics, Heather Blevins, Blue River Valley. And in volleyball, Lindsay Hitchman, Mishawaka. And Nicole Necessary, Winchester Community. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause to these 1999-2000 IHSAA Mental Attitude Award winners.
Well, those are the Mental Attitude Award winners, and the Farm Bureau Insurance group has been so very, very special to high school athletics over the last several years. They're the corporate sponsor. And our congratulations to all those winners. Let's go down now to Bob Nagel with our buddy Gary Dunn. I see, Bob, that Gary rented another suit this week.
Gary, you're being accused of renting another suit this week by your old buddy Jerry. But, you know, Hall of Famers do those kind of things, sir, you know?
Well, Jerry Baker, I've known Jerry a long time, and probably for the first 20 years he knew me, he never saw me in a coat and tie, so I can understand his shock.
Gary, this morning we saw 31 records set. And obviously class basketball is only 3 years old. But outstanding games this morning, and it promised to be a great slate tonight. When you look at it, this has just been a phenomenal year for the high school teams and the individual players. We've had it all this year.
Well, I think that's true, and I think this first game tonight, Brebeuf is a team that I saw early in the year and was very impressed with. Leo Clem has just put together a team that works like precision on defense. That's where they've won the game so far tonight in the first half. Their team plays together well, and I think Michael Bennett, number 32, deserves a lot of credit. He was a perimeter player last year, but they needed him inside, and he's made a big difference. And Jon Owens, their guard, number 12, they're just a very impressive unit. Shane Power, impressive, as you would expect, but Shane needs more help. You know, he can't do it by himself.
Quickly, give us a little preview of tonight, the Class 4A Championship, 1-2. It's like the main course.
Well, it's the irresistible force and the immovable object. It's what they call in Las Vegas a pick 'em game. You know, both teams have that extra dimension, Zach Randolph, Marion, Jared Jeffries, Bloomington North. But both teams are well coached, both teams play good defense, and both teams have great supporting players like Sean May on Bloomington North, Deuce Miller, Matt Bax on Marion. So it should be a classic.
All right, Gary, thanks. And I know you'll be sitting right in the middle, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, Gary Donna.
With my tie on.
With his tie on. Gary Donna joining us here at halftime. We'll be back. You're watching the IHSA State Finals on the LaCie Broadcasting Network.
The IHSA Boys State Basketball Championships are brought to you in part by Light of the World Christian Center and by Ball State University. Everything you need, visit them at bsu.edu.
Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse, downtown Indianapolis. Gary Baker along with Dave Nicholson. Dave, all we've in effect done now, from based on what we've seen this afternoon, is change colors of uniforms, because in all three games now, it's been a sizable lead at halftime for the team that eventually won the game.
That's a real sound point. There's some key stats out there, Jerry. 7 steals for Brebeuf. Outstanding field goal percentage, 59%. on the other side of the court. Andrean 40% from the field, 9 turnovers. I think that's a difference in the ball game.
All right, let's go to Bob Nagel. He has the other coach from this championship game. Bob?
Leo Clem. Leo Clem is with us. And Leo, great first half. You guys got off to a great start, did it with defense.
Thank you. We've been doing that all year, and we've been very consistent. We do that in practice daily, just a continuation of what we do, and that's how we treat the state championship game.
Any changes at halftime? I know they've got to try to maybe go to power a little bit more. You're going to be watching for that inside game?
That's what they'll try to do, but we're playing 5 guys on the other team, and we continue to structure our defense that way.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Doing a great job.
Thank you very much.
All right, Leo Clem is with us here at halftime. We want to remind you that Circle City Car Company would like to thank all the area schools who participated in the first annual Circle City Company $1 Million MVP Challenge. They want to say thank you for that effort. We'll take a break and be back at Conseco Fieldhouse in just a moment on the IHSA Basketball Network.
All right, there's a look at Conseco Fieldhouse starting to fill up now in anticipation of the 4A game for those late arrivals to watch that Marion Bloomington North game. Your top scorers in the first half for Brebeuf, a well-balanced scoring, Dave. 8 points out of Marcus Bennett and Michael Bennett, and 7 from Jon Owens. For Andrean, a dozen points out of Shane Power to go along with 4 rebounds. Nobody else had more than 3 points for Andrean, though.
And a young man that really helped Brebeuf off the bench, Troutman, came in and got those 6. Interesting point. Only 4 free throws taken in that first half, all by Andrean.
I'm going to say Brebeuf never got to the line.
Never got to the line.
They shot the ball so well, though. They shot, as Bob Dave pointed out, 16 to 27 for 59.3%, as compared to 40%, 8 of 20 for Andrean. And the Braves throw it away.
It's a good backdoor cut, but it just went through the hands of Michael Bennett.
Shane Power led the way for Andrean with 12 points and 4 rebounds. 8 points and 4 assists for Michael Bennett, and very quickly a substitution for Brebeuf coming back into the ballgame, Sonny Troutman, and going out as Evan Beadle.
We've talked so much about the team behind has made a run. Now's the time for Andrean to make that run here at the start of the second half. Be interesting to see what happens the next 3 or 4 minutes.
Yeah. Lafayette Central Catholic and Westview both had sizable leads at halftime. But in both cases, Winchester and Union Dugger came back, got into the ball game, but just literally ran out of steam by the time they climbed to the top of the mountain. There's another defensive effort by Sonny Troutman coming up to the court and gets the layup. Well, this young man has had a really nice game. Now he has 8, so 3 players on Brebeuf's roster have 8 points apiece. And the lead goes to 35 to 20. In case you're wondering, it got as high as 15 points back in the latter part of the second quarter of this game, and that's where it is right now.
I talked earlier about how Brebeuf likes to defend inside first. You see how they rotated just on that play as I was speaking. They like to guard the 15-foot range and then do the best they can on perimeter.
Well, I thought your early observation, Dave Nicholson, was right on. They just seal things off in the middle. Here's the long-range 3, and you, if you go in there, you may never come out. It's like a vacuum in there.
I wish we had the stat of deflections and steals, but I noticed Coach Swan, he was right on the money. When he said we've got to quit giving the ball up so easily and quit letting him have deflections.
Shane Power with his 14th point of the night with 6.5 minutes to go here in the third. And a near steal, but in the process a personal foul on Elliot Borden. And that's the first on Mr. Borden tonight. Not been a lot of fouls. And interestingly enough, maybe we'll take a look at it again here first before I make this comment.
Okay, you're going to watch Elliot Borden try to make a play here on a good hustle play. He comes up, almost steals the ball, but he gets a piece of the right arm.
And despite going at warp speed as we had both of the games earlier today in the first half, Brebeuf committed only 3 turnovers and Andrean 9. And that's not a lot for the type of game that's been played out there tonight.
It's not a lot, except when your opponent only turns it over 3. That means the way Brebeuf is shooting the ball, you can't give them such extra attempts.
Well, I'll tell you, Michael Bennett's had a nice night. Great body control there. He's the first player for the Braves to hit double figures. He's at 10. And the lead is back to 15 again. Power drops it off in the corner, and there's the baseline shot by Elliot Borden. Only his second field goal of the game, and 4 points of the night for Mr. Borden. 37 to 24 in favor of Brebeuf. They have been ahead since the first bucket of the game. Scored the first couple of field goals and have held on and had the lead as high as 15, and right now it's at 13. They double down low and a terrific baseline move and a reverse layup for Borden. So back-to-back buckets by Borden.
By Bennett.
By Michael Bennett, 12 points for him.
Both 32s.
Mm-hmm.
That was a great move by Michael Bennett. He went left and then spun back right and then came under the basket and put up a backhand layup the last time down.
Now the foul is on Borden.
Okay, we're going to see a replay here. There's a nice pass into Borden, and you saw the foul on the screen.
It is on Bennett. Michael Bennett's second personal foul. Nobody in any kind of foul trouble because there haven't been enough fouls called in this game. Bob?
Reeves Buick Pontiac Hummer is located at 1250 U.S. 31 South in Greenwood. That's Reeves Buick Pontiac Hummer in Greenwood. Phone 317-882-8425. That's 317-882-8425.
You think Ray McCallum is kind of liking what he sees here, number 32, Michael Bennett?
Well, Ray, who's the coach at Ball State, had a really nice year also this year.
Had a great year. Indiana College has had a tremendous
they did.
Year. Talk about Butler, Indiana State, Ball State, Notre Dame, IU, Purdue. IU got beat the first round. But.
Purdue losing tonight. There's the rebound by Power. Notre Dame still alive, going to the finals, to the semifinals of the NIT. Power coming right down the power lane. Rebound comes off to Brebeuf. Boy, they're just gold shirts everywhere out there, the maroon and gold, and a foul is going to be called.
To this point in the game, Jerry, Brebeuf has just been a step quicker on everything.
Yep, they have.
To the ball, reacting on defense. They've just been a step quicker all night.
Rashad Pace gets the personal foul. Indeed, it started out that way, literally, Dave, right from the opening tip. You had the feeling that they were a step quicker, and they haven't lost anything in the process. Out of the 4:45 mark of the third quarter of this game, 39-26 for Buck over Andrean for the 3A championship. Well, they really bring that offense out high sometimes.
Yeah, I think they're spreading that zone defense out a little bit. It's a help side man-to-man or matchup zone. And as you can see, when they spread it out, that leaves big gaps in the middle for Michael Bennett right there to work.
Yeah, and that's what happens, and you're right on the money. As Michael Bennett continues to play great basketball, 14 points. He scored 6 of the 8 Brebeuf has in the third quarter of this game. They power it inside, get it back out to Staten, and a whistle and a foul against Brebeuf. It is on Jon Owens. That'll be number 2 on the 6-foot senior from Brebeuf, and we will get a timeout, 22nd timeout by Brebeuf. And that brings us over to Bob Nagel.
Thank you, Jerry. Strong foundations for a remarkable future in life. That's what Marion College offers. Call Marion College toll-free at 1-800-772-7264 or visit their website at www.marion.edu. to learn how you can begin your remarkable future at Marion College.
Brebeuf got into the championship with wins over Beach Grove and Chittard in the Mount Vernon sectional. Won the regional at Shelbyville with Matt Comparato coming off the bench and scoring 23 points. Beat Danville in the afternoon game of the Washington semi. And then down number 4 Evansville Matter Day on a Jon Owens three-pointer at the buzzer, 66-63. The tip off the mark, but the rebound taken down again by Brebeuf, and they'll set up the offense. Take it down inside and get the almost uncontested layup, and as you might have suspected, it's Michael Bennett again. He's having a great third quarter. He equals his first half point output now with 8, so 16 on the night.
You know, coaches talk about defending every possession. I know I almost have to say that Brebeuf has done that tonight. Every possession, they're all over the basketball, and they're in passing lanes. All 5 people move with every pass.
Yeah, there's nothing given to anybody out there so far tonight. Offensive foul being called against Andrean. It is on 24, Josh Fry. That is his first. We'll take a timeout, 43-26, Brebeuf.
The IHSA Boys State Basketball Championships are brought to you in part by Indiana State University, the way college is supposed to be, and by Farm Bureau Insurance, solutions you need from a company you know.
Almost a capacity crowd settling in at Conseco Fieldhouse to watch the final 3.5 minutes of the third quarter, and then the fourth quarter of this AAA game, and then the 4A championship coming up between Marion and Bloomington North. Here with your field goal percentages so far, and Brebeuf, who shot the ball well in the first half, continue to do it in the second half, Dave.
They have continued because they're getting real high quality shots down around the basket.
Michael Bennett scored the last 8 points for the Brebeuf Braves. Nice job of tapping the ball, keeping it alive for Andrean. Andrean down by their biggest deficit of the game so far. Here's the tip up. A couple of times would not go for Shane Power. Andrean gets it back and fires from long range, and the rebound on the floor. Now stolen away. Now stolen away again. Nice effort by Andrean's Josh Fry, but he had his foot on the sideline.
His foot on the sideline. Bob Anderson, the official, right on top of it. Good call.
Well, Bob's been around for a while, hasn't he?
He's been around, been official. A veteran, been a good one.
He has been one of the best.
I think I saw something that last series by Andrean after that timeout. It seems to me like they came down and attacked the basket immediately. They did get three attempts. They're not going to fool around. They know it's time to go. If they got any chance, they got to go to the basket and shoot the basketball.
And we're less than 3 minutes to play now in the third, and the biggest lead of the ball game, which goes to 19, as they get a cut inside from Jon Owens. Owens' first contributions offensively in the third quarter, 9 of the night. The lead goes to 19.
Big defensive break down there by Andre, and Owens ended up wide open.
Power had it stripped away, and it's out of bounds. The last touch by Brebeuf. Dave and I were talking during the timeout commercial break about the level of play of Brebeuf from a pure physical aspect. They started that way, and they have not slowed down one iota.
Contest everything.
Everything. There's a good example right there. No matter where the ball is or what the situation, they are in your face. And if you're Andrean, it takes you out of your game, and it starts to wear you out a little bit. Shane Power out high, contesting the pass out there. He has the job of trying to stop this man, and nobody's been able to do it. Michael Bennett with 10 points in the quarter, 18 on the night, and that's right at his scoring average. And look at Leo Klim come out, bounce up and down, and a full timeout has been taken. It is 47-26. Brebeuf leads Andrean for the 3A championship. And we are live at Conseco Fieldhouse. Bob?
Reeves Buick Pontiac Hummer is located at 1250 US 31 South in Greenwood. That's Reeves Buick Pontiac Hummer in Greenwood, Indiana. Phone 317-882-8425. That's 317-882-8425.
You know, I met your youngsters, Joe and Bob. You ought to get them a Hummer. You know.
Well, they make them there in Mishawaka.
You know, they're pretty good-sized guys, man.
They got the new family model coming out.
Yeah?
You can go to the grocery store, drive right over the grocery carts. They don't ding you anymore. You can run them right over.
Bob's got his fine young sons down here today and got them working.
Yeah, we got them working for their dinner tonight. What they don't know is most of the restaurants will be closed.
That's
by the time
right.
We get
that's
out
that's
here,
what I figured, yes.
Now, this is a great town, isn't it, Indianapolis? Oh. It's a great experience. When you think about the people coming down next week for the NCAAs, the people that are down here this week, they're all walking around saying, what a magnificent city Indianapolis is.
And the change just gets better and better and better as years gone by. Well, we got the 4A championship game coming up shortly with the numbers 1 and 2 teams in the state of Indiana. So wherever you are, whatever you're doing, don't you dare wander off, because that's coming up next. You'll see a couple of candidates for Mr. Basketball, an undefeated team, and another team that in the process, the other team being, of course, Marion, that's lost only 1 at 27-1, so that should be a terrific game. Dave Nicholson, I don't know what Andrean does right now to get back in this ball game.
I was just thinking, if I were Clint Swan over there, what would you say to your ball club? But one thing you got to say, we're not going to fall completely apart. The last time down, Jon Owens was wide open on the basket, uncontested layup. We're going to get back to playing real hard defense. We're going to play this thing out. I would say don't even look at the scoreboard. Just play. Play as hard as you can. Get after folks. If you make a mistake, it's okay. Attack the basket, but let's get things going, as Brebeuf is in the last 306 is on an 8-0 run. They're now shooting 59% for the game.
They need to get Shane Power offensively into the game. Not that he's not trying. He has 14 points, but whenever they win, you see his name at the top of the scoring column, and he's struggling right now just to get a shot away.
And I look for number 21. I've been looking for him all night. And Staten, Nathaniel Staten, to get involved. He only has one field goal in this ballgame.
Nice defensive play this time by Andrean. They get the uncontested layup, and it's knocked away and out of bounds off the miss.
Foul call.
And a foul is called in the process against Brebeuf.
Andrean kind of dodged a bullet there because they missed a wide open opportunity. Here's a replay inside. Watch this. They get the turnover, and then the ball comes down to Pace inside. He just doesn't get it over the front edge. And then I thought they were fortunate in getting the foul call.
Marcus Bennett commits that foul. It's number 2 on Marcus with a minute 42 to play now here in the third quarter of this game. And it's been all Brebeuf tonight. They make another steal. They are everywhere. 3-on-1 break all the way into the uncontested layup that's missed. The putback is missed again, tipped again, and finally back up and good. It took them 3 tries, but it's Jon Owens who comes up with points 10 at 11, and the lead goes to 49-26. Right out front, and Andrean finally makes that scoreboard move in their favor as Borden picks up his second field goal this quarter. He has scored 6 points, 6 of the 8 Andrean has on the board up there. It's 49-28.
Well, Andrean is trying to put more pressure on the basketball, and they're getting after folks, but Brebeuf just pretty strong and pretty good with the basketball.
Well, the Brebeuf Braves, their first sectional win since 1991. Here comes Power. And Shane will have 16 points to his credit tonight. Last year, Brebeuf lost to Plainfield in the championship game of the sectional, 78-67. What a turnaround they have had.
Another steal on the turnover there, Jerry. Andrean's making a few things happen here.
And they will force a foul on Brebeuf, and the foul will go against number 24, Sonny Crompton. That's the first of the night on Sonny. We'll take a look at it again.
Going to see the slam here, but Power's coming up. He makes a good, he reached with his offhand, and that's the correct hand to reach with. You don't reach across the body, and he has an open look and takes no chances. 2 hands on the ball. If you're going to dunk, don't go with 1. Go with 2.
2 shots.
Make sure you have the basketball.
And Grant at the line, and they're the only team that's been to the line tonight. Nathaniel Staten will get his 4th point of the game. He had a 3-pointer back in the second quarter of the game. Out of the lineup now for Brebeuf is number 20, Jarvis Joyner. And Matt Comparato will come back into the ball game for the Braves tonight. Second free throw attempt also good by Staten, giving him 5 points on the night. And Andrean 4 out of 4 from the line in the second quarter. Now some full court pressure.
I'll tell you how tough it is for Andrean, and they've made 3 or 4 good plays, and there's almost another steal, but they're still down 17.
Exactly.
I mean, once you're in that deep hole, it's just very, very difficult against a good ball club, and Brebeuf is certainly that.
Well, here's the outlet pass, and they'll get the bucket and the foul. The foul is on Elliot Borden. That'll be 2 on him. The field goal is by Michael Bennett.
You know, they could have really called an intentional foul, though, on Elliot Borden. He wouldn't want to see that, the young man, but he did not make a play on the ball. He simply two-hand pushed in the back.
Was it Union Duggar or was it Winchester that said we were not used to playing from this far behind? One of the coaches or the players
that
today?
That was Union.
And that's basically what we're facing right now. They had said, you know, we had a great year. We're not used to being that far behind, and it had an impact on them mentally, if not physically.
And I don't think there's any question about it. And, you know, Andrean's coming in here with a long win streak going. They've won 21 games in a row coming into the night. They don't know what it is to be behind or to lose.
Shane Power had his shot blocked, picked back up, and will not get the roll. Still battling for it. Andrean comes out of it with it, loses it. It's still a battle. Now it's 2-1. And back defensively is Gernak, but nothing to do back there except get out of the way and get the bucket by Sonny Trotman. He's in double figures, and that's the end of the third quarter as that shot went in and rimmed and came out, would not have counted anyway. Through 3, it is all Brebeuf for the 3A championship. Brebeuf Braves 54, the Andrean Fighting 59ers 32. Fourth quarter coming up on the LaCie Broadcasting IHSAA Television Network.
The IHSA Boys State Basketball Championships are brought to you in part by Methodist Sports Medicine Center. We keep you in the game. And by Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
Nighttime in Indy, and you can see across the way Andrean's head coach Clint Swan in his third year with a 68-9 record, a winning percentage of 88%. His first head coaching job, and right now he's got his hands full with his Andrean Fighting 59ers trailing 54-32. Michael Bennett did a lot of the damage in the third quarter. Brebeuf, he had 13 points. He has hit 10 of 12 field goals, has 21 points on the night.
Well, Clint Swan's done a great job at Andrean. He's 68-9 in those 3 years coming into this ballgame.
There's the block. Another good defensive play turned in by Marcus Bennett. Owens, Joyner, Bennett, Michael, and Marcus. Here's Power with the follow-up.
He threw that first one up, knew he didn't have a shot, but he also knew he had the best angle to rebound. That was a pass to himself, in effect. Very smart play.
And Andrean still has only 4 players who have scored. Off-balance shot rims out of there for Brebeuf, Sonny Trotman. One of the starters, Justin Castellanos, has not scored in this game tonight. Only five players have scored for the Brebeuf Braves. And one of their starters, Evan Beadle, has not scored yet tonight. Here's the steal. The give up on the near side. The shot is off the mark. The foul is called on Michael Bennett. That'll be three on him. And once again, Shane Power in the middle of things that are happening out there.
Made a good play. He made the steal, brought it down, and made an excellent pass over to Staten.
Leo Klim wants a very quick timeout, a full timeout, only 54 seconds into the fourth quarter. He does not want to see anything start going the other way. 7:06 to go in the game. 54-34. Brebeuf leads on the IHSAA Television Network.
Here's a replay of that last series. You're going to see Shane Power step in, make a good move, draw the defense, and dump down to Nathaniel Staten. And so Staten's going to go to the free throw line with two free ones.
And again, I reiterate that only, I think I said nobody for Brebeuf had been to the line. That's not quite true. Michael Bennett got there in the third quarter, and that's the only free throw that Brebeuf has had all night long.
That's amazing. A team that had 20 and only made one free throw in the process, only taken one free throw.
Bob?
Well, I thank the folks from Noble Romans for sponsoring our game tonight. Noble Romans, a proud sponsor of Indiana High School basketball action. And they took on the formidable task of feeding our crew today and did a great job. We congratulate them on two fine performances today.
Full court pressure now by Andrean. They've got to get something going. We're a minute into the fourth quarter of this game, and they're down by 19 points.
And Shane Power went down pretty hard, was kind of gimpy on one ankle, but he's a gamer. He's up and going, and he's checking it out right now. You see him there in the free throw lane, number 20, and he's trying to walk it off.
You can be hurt next week, can't you? Not tonight.
Right up in the face of Brebeuf, or Andrean is... Andy Gurnak. Rebound taken off by Andrean. Elliot Borden, averaging just about 6.5 rebounds per game.
You got to take the first good shot along. There it is. You've got to do that if you're Andrean. You have no chance. If you don't, you put the ball right back up the basket.
Shane Power trying to take it upon himself to get the job done. He has hit the 20-point mark now. Shane comes in averaging 26.3. And I mentioned earlier, when you look back at the games they have won in the tournament this year, it's been Shane Power who's powered the way at 33 against New Prairie and 33 against Calumet, 35 against Fort Wayne Concordia, the number 9 team of the state. And then last Saturday night at the Frankfort Semi-State against Pendleton Heights, 21 points and 11 rebounds. So he is the guy who carries the mail for this Andrean Fighting 59ers team. Brebeuf just keeps going, and this time they throw up a prayer, and it's answered. Michael Bennett with 23 points now. He can do nothing wrong right now.
You know, if I were Andrean, I'd put Brebeuf to the free throw line. If they have one weakness, it might be there. They only shoot 63% as a team. They're not going to win with the clock running. I'd take a chance, put them at the free throw line, start fouling a little bit. If they make them, you got the same result. But if they miss a few, you've got a long shot. A long shot at best.
That long shot at best is right. Andy Gurnak gets his first foul. Shane Powers has really been a power for this ball club tonight.
Crossover dribble, up and under, good body hang, and watch this touch on the basketball. Hit every side of the rim, bounced in. Great play.
He was tied for seventh in the state in scoring this year with an average of 26-2. And tonight he has come away with 20 points. Still some time left, 5.5 minutes to go in this game.
And it's really tough to press a team like Brebeuf. They've got such great ball handlers. They're strong with the ball. They don't turn it over very much. And, you know, they're just fundamentally sound.
Power comes off with the rebound, but he is, wow, he was the man behind Michael Bennett, and Bennett gets called for the personal foul.
That was kind of a surprise, and
yes.
The indication was Shane Power extended his hand to help him up, like, hey, friend, you got a bad call. I got a break there, and you're going to see this. It looked to me like that Power was the one that fouled on this. If we pick it up on the long rebound there, it looks to me like that Power went over the top, but they called it on Brebeuf.
And that's the fourth foul on Michael Bennett, who has 23 points and has really ignited things here in the second half for the Braves of Brebeuf Jesuit School. 3 minutes into the fourth quarter.
Leo Klim knows his ball club better than anyone, but, you know, as a coach, I might think about setting Michael Bennett out for a couple of minutes. It's not impossible for Andrean to make a run. I'd want Michael Bennett in there if they did make a run.
The reach in, knocked away by Rashad Pace. Pace will get the return pass and score. Pace is the guy that set that up when he knocked the ball away, and those are the first points that Rashad has scored since the first quarter of tonight's game. Back the other way, a 2-on-1, the quick foul. It's on Lathaniel Staten. That's the first of the night on the 6'2 senior. One of the starting unit for this Andrean, the Fighting 59ers, of Clint Swan. Interesting that Clint Swan, and we're going to get
just
conversation.
Yeah, you see what's going on over there. Coach Clem calls Michael Bennett over, and he says, whatever you do, don't foul. I'm going to leave you in, but be very intelligent. Don't get a bump. Somebody comes at you, step out of the way. I want you in the ballgame.
So Bennett will go to the line where he has had the only free throw attempt of the entire game tonight for Brebeuf. And it rolls out of it. He'll get another. What I was going to say was Clint Swan, who was the head coach of Andrean, also attended Duggar High School and played with Joey Hart, which is the current coach, Joe Hart's son. So it's amazing how all these things intertwine throughout the basketball world. And of course, Duggar was here earlier today and lost the Class A battle.
Well, there, Coach Clem is taking Michael Bennett out, and one reason, he's got four fouls, the main reason, but also he's a 59% free throw shooter at the line. They might want to start fouling him.
Well, that's a great pass up court, and Shane Power contributes his sixth point of the quarter, 22 on the night.
That was an equally great catch.
Yes,
not
it
very
was.
Many young men could catch that pass. It was just so.
That was truly a football pass going the length of the court, and Power went down and got it. Will get the foul call against Andrean, and that personal foul is on 42 Rashad Pace.
His fourth. His third?
Third foul I had.
Okay, thank you. I had him for four. That would make a big difference.
We'll see how long Brebeuf will go without Michael Bennett on the sideline. And we'll see Brebeuf at the line again with the number 20, Jarvis Joyner. He scored a couple of field goals back in the first quarter of this game. We have not had any contributions from him since then. This is the free throw. And with 4.5 minutes to go, it's a 57-41 lead for Brebeuf. And there's not much that Andrean can do as far as running any kind of a game plan. They got to get it and fire it up, and that's just what you said a while ago,
yeah.
Dave.
Got to take the first good opportunity there, and they came down and drew the foul. And
Sonny Troutman's second foul.
Coach Clem is here going to see a replay, and then I'll tell you about what Coach is doing. But they're working on Michael Bennett over there. There's a steal by Andrean. Good punch, dribble all the way down. Great pass.
With two shots for Andrean.
Here comes the next one where the foul's called right here. Take it down inside, and what you saw was a swat down by Troutman. And here you were asking a question. Here comes Michael Bennett. You've been answered.
Yep. He just gave him the blow. Sitting down, talked to him for a couple of seconds.
You got to think he can go 2 minutes without a foul and maintain this lead they've got now, which is at 15. And if they do, Brebeuf's in great shape. That would be 2 minutes left in the game, 15-point lead. That's the way a coach thinks.
10 points for Borden. Well, he couldn't sit. He got too long because he was burning a hole in the seat over there, as hot as he's been. He has been on fire. He has been sizzling. Here's the breakaway, and they could not get the ball to Sonny Troutman. Troutman was there all right. But they threw it too far, too fast, and the turnover gives the ball back to Andrean. And now Andrean's coach, Clint Swan, is pushing his ball club up defensively or offensively to go help out because, once again, Brebeuf kind of jumps into a little pressure when you least expect it out
there. It's really interesting to watch Coach Clem over there.
Three-pointer for Shane Power. And Power has scored four of the five field goals that Andrean has in this fourth quarter. Quickly up court, Owens. He will get the bucket. And once again, it's the same old story. They put so much pressure on down here and fight so hard that they can't get back defensively, and somebody's breaking away for Brebeuf, getting uncontested layups here. And we'll have a hell ball. Possession arrow. We'll give it to Brebeuf.
Brebeuf.
With 3.5 minutes to go.
Before I started to make there a minute ago, you would think Coach Clem with 13-point lead with 3:29 might relax, but he's more nervous than anyone in the house because he knows good and well that in 3:29, Andrean can come back.
Absolutely. 20-second timeout now for Andrean. We'll take a look at the replay of this last scenario here with 3.5 minutes to go.
Okay, loose ball in the corner. That's just great hustle by Brebeuf. You saw Michael Bennett, who else, go down there and knock that thing back in bounds to his teammate, and a jump ball is called.
The Brebeuf Braves' last trip to this high of the ladder was back in 91. They were the state runners-up to Gary Roosevelt, losing 51-32. That was in the Allen Henderson era back at Brebeuf. They've won four sectionals, two regionals, couple of semi-states. They've had terrific tennis programs at Brebeuf. The boys' tennis teams were the champions in 74, and the girls were champions on five different occasions back in the early 80s when they had great tennis teams over there. Full-court pressure now being applied. Got a held ball, and this time it goes the other way.
Position error pointing the other way, and official right on top of it. Andrean has really stepped up their defense. They're double-teaming the ball. They've got to take all kinds of chances. 3-14, 13-point margin, certainly not impossible.
Andrean, now we knew they would have not tossed in the towel. You suggested earlier they'll just keep playing hard. You suggest don't look at the scoreboard, just play hard. Knocked away, right into the lap of the coaching staff over there. Kevin Briskey, Ron Frederick, Rodney Pace, Mark Horvath, all the assistants for head coach Clint Swan.
I'd find number 20 if I were Bert Andrean.
Went over the top of the board. It'll belong to Brebeuf. Yeah, I think I agree with you there, Dave. I'd find him every time down the floor. Because he has been the guy that's carried him. He has 9 points in the quarter and 25 in the night. We're talking about Shane Power.
Mm-hmm.
Quickly across the timeline, Sonny Trotman drops it inside. Another layup for Michael Bennett. And Bennett now with 26 points.
That time he had to reach behind his back and catch the ball. You know, what a great pair of hands he has.
Bennett came into the game averaging 17.3. And he just exploded in the fourth quarter with 13 points on 10 of 12 shooting. He had 21 going into the fourth quarter. Quickly up court, Jon Owens. Batted away by Power and traveling call before the defensive play anyway.
Well, you're going to see Coach Clem take a timeout. I know he wants his team to push it out, but he's up 15 points with 2:27. I'd be surprised if Brebeuf now does not start using the clock.
Just take it and hold it as they did sometimes. First and second quarter, they did it and came away with a bucket each time. We'll take a break with 2:27 to go in the fourth quarter. 61-46, Brebeuf leads Andrea. Along with Dave Nicholson and Bob Nagel, this is Jerry Baker. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse, downtown Indianapolis. It has been all Brebeuf for the 3A title. They've led by as many as 23. They're up right now by 15 with 2:27 to go. And Andrean has won, as they pointed out earlier, 21 straight. They lost at Merrillville on the 11th of December. That's the last time that they tasted defeat. Since then, they've run off 21 straight, but right now they're in trouble against this Brebeuf ball club.
They're in trouble. Andrean's going to have to score a bunch in a hurry, and you can bet Brebeuf is going to put the basketball away when they get their hands in it.
Well, they do trap well, don't they? And they caused a lot of turnovers in this game. There were 6 turnovers in the third quarter by Andrean when all that pressure hit them.
And Nathaniel Staten just got caught there at the 10-second line and grabbed the dribblers who went past and picked up his second personal.
Now the turnovers have gone 4, 5, and 6 first, second, and third quarter for Andrean. Contrarily, Brebeuf with only 2 turnovers in the first, 1 in the second, and 4 in the third quarter, taking pretty good care of the basketball.
Taking very good care of the basketball in a game like this, Brebeuf.
First free throw was good. Jarvis Gunner now with his 5 points on the board. He is 1 out of 2 from the line. And he came in not a good free throw shooter, only 59%.
Tell you a young man I hadn't heard too much about for Brebeuf, number 24, Sonny Trotman. You gave him a call earlier, but he's a freshman, and he's come in and put up 10 points in the second, third quarter, made a big difference in this ballgame.
He sparked him in that second quarter of play. And again, they come out with a loose ball. This time, Jon Owens. Now we'll see what they do offensively. Whether they bring it out and eat
they're
some
in their spread.
And a quick foul by Andrean. That's their only option right now. Foul is either on Staten or Gernak.
I mentioned earlier, Brebeuf is not a particularly good free throw shooter, but unfortunately for Andrean, Jon Owens is one of their best at 75.5% from the free throw line. He's going to be up there with the running balls.
Gernak gets the foul, his second. And Jon Owens will travel to the stripe for the first time tonight.
The Brebeuf crowd behind us is starting to celebrate just a little bit, but from a coaching standpoint, you don't want to see any celebration on your players' faces till that horn blows, I tell you.
John Power, Shane Power forcing up the shot. It's off the mark, and Brebeuf brings it back up court, and there's another quick foul. Andy Gernak with his third. This may be too little too late, because Brebeuf is just, to be honest about it, dominated this game. And this is a replay of what, if you were not with us earlier today for the A and the AA, one team busts out front, establishes the lead, and then the other team plays catch up the rest of the game. And in the cases this afternoon, with Winchester and with Union Duggar, they got back into the game. And Andrean, I'm not sure they ever did get quite back into it.
So. They never got close enough to really put the fear into Brebeuf tonight. And there's the freshman we were talking about, Sonny Troutman, up there at the line. He's a good one.
One out of two for him, 11 points total in the corner. Nice shot by Andy Gurnick. That is his first points of the night. And another quick personal foul. And it may take an eternity to play this last minute and a half here. And the foul is against Rashad Pace. And that is the fourth one on him. Andrean, members of that Lake Conference, Brebeuf and Independent School here in the city. And don't forget now, we've got a terrific battle coming up between the two top teams in the 4A classification in the state of Indiana. A lot of folks have been buying tickets to come and see this particular game with the number one team, Bloomington North, and number two, Marion, as they battle for the state championship in the Class 4A. And we'll have it for you live here.
Jon Owens missed his last two. That's very unlike him, being a 75.5% shooter there. He normally is very dependable at the free throw line.
14 points on the night for Jon Owens, three below his scoring average of 17 per game. Inside a minute and a half, the pull-up quick shot out of time by Staten, off the mark, and it'll be out of bounds to Andrean.
Shane Power continues to show outstanding athletic ability.
Bob Anderson, the official, called an official's timeout to bring Andy Gurnick over to the sideline.
I think we got a little blood on him. Yeah. Of course, the rule is must leave the game.
Spraying his right knee. 24, Josh Fry. So they will bring Josh Fry into the lineup while that is taken care of. A minute 22 to go. After the game, we'll have the ceremonies, the presentation of the runner-up medals and the championship medals, and the championship trophy, and of course the Medal Attitude Award winner. Still battling both clubs. Now we're inside a minute. We're actually getting to that minute mark right now. Here's the near steal, and instead a nice tip, and the basket goes in, and it counts, and the foul is on Elliott Borden, number three on him. Everything that could go right has gone right tonight for Brebeuf.
Well, now you're going to see the Brebeuf kids start to feel the celebration, and you can't blame them. You know, it's got to be a wonderful feeling as a player and as a coach if you're ahead 49-67 with over a minute and 2 seconds to go. 18-point lead, a chance to take it to 19.
So Joyner gets the field goal and goes to the line with a chance for the three-point play. Out of the lineup, Rashad Pace for Andrean, a junior. And Joyner completes the three-point play. He has 9 points. Three seniors on this starting lineup for Andrean. Three-pointer in the way. Good by Lathaniel Staten. He has 2 field goals tonight. They've both been three-pointers.
There's a flyout.
Well, they've done that a lot tonight. Off the mark, into the hands of Josh Fry. Now we have 40 seconds to play. Staten again from long range.
Long range. That was 5 feet behind the three line.
Here is the rebound and the putback by Power. Shane with a nice fourth quarter, 11 points in the quarter.
27 in the ball game. I have Shane Power for, he's a blue chipper.
Power commits the foul, and now we're going to get a total influx. In fact, an entire new Brebeuf squad will come on the floor at the next dead ball. And 4 of the 5 will come in between the free throws.
Coach Clem's going to let his players hear the ovation, and he's also going to give those young men over at the bench say, "I was in the final."
It'll be in the official box. Here they come, and listen to the crowd behind us here. Blake Ertl is coming in. Let's see, number 40, James Martin is on the floor. 35, Ben Pitts is out there. I'm looking around. 45. Kevin McCamick is on the floor. And Andrean will also make a change or two. And it looks like Shane Power is coming out of the lineup. And this young man has just played his heart out the entire season.
He should receive a tremendous ovation, and he is, and he deserves it. I had him for 27 on the ball.
That's right. He is tied for number 20 with Daryl Warren of Linden on the Indiana career scoring list. Over 2,000 points, 2,083 coming into the game. Owens good on the free throw.
I coached against Daryl Warren when he played at Linden. I was at the school of Darlington.
Is that right?
Absolutely. He's a great player.
The number one scorer in Lake County history, four-year starter. We talked about his physical problems early on. And he will go to the sideline knowing that he's poured his heart out tonight, but it just simply wasn't enough. Here's the Elliott Borden field goal. It's a dozen points now for Elliott. 27 points for Shane Power, and that's what he'll finish up with. We're down to the final 9 seconds of this game. The 3A title's going to belong to the Brebeuf Braves as Blake Ertl hits the little floater down the lane.
And that's big for Blake Ertl.
Got
his mark in the scoreboard.
And that's all she wrote, and here's the celebration. Well, stay with us. We have ceremonies coming up. The presentation of the runner-up medal and trophy, the championship medal and trophy, and the Medal Attitude Award winner. Final 72-56 for Brebeuf, the 3A champions tonight.
We're back on the floor of the Conseco Fieldhouse with the head coach, Leo Clem, of Indianapolis Brebeuf. And congratulations, coach. Your team took defense to a new level tonight.
Thank you very much. Really, it's an extension of what we do every day. Our goal is to get better every day, and we talked about that all week. Rather than talking about state championship, much like when you teach a class, each day you want to grow, get better, be more alert. It all starts with concentration, and really, before that, it's attitude, and our kids have a tremendous attitude.
You also had great intensity. Every possession, offensive end, defensive end, every minute of every quarter of this game, you were 100% into this game. Your kids were, too, and it really paid off.
Well, again, that's our approach. We don't talk about winning a game. We talk about winning every possession. And we focus that way, and that's how we practice.
Well, congratulations. A great effort here tonight. You had a worthy opponent, and you look very good winning.
Thank you very much.
All right, Leo Clem, the head coach of Indianapolis Brebeuf. Let's go to Jerry Baker.
All right, Jerry. Just handed out the Medal Attitude Award, by the way, to Shane Power of Andrean. He finished up with 27 points on 12 of 23 shooting, 2 out of 5 from the three-point area, 1 out of 2 free throws. He had a dozen rebounds, 1 assist, and 5 steals tonight, and was very obviously, Dave Nicholson, one of the key players, not just tonight, but all season long for Andrean's Fighting 59ers. There he is
with his mom. You've got to understand that he's a great athlete, but to have the qualities to qualify for this Mental Attitude Award says a lot for Shane Power, and it's a very popular decision here tonight.
And I'm sure he would much like to have that and the other award to go along with it.
But in the long run, Jerry, it comes down sometimes sure, he'd like to win the state. He'd love to win the state, but when it's all said and done, what kind of person are you? And that says a lot about that young man.
And that lady to the left of the screen representing Farm Bureau Insurance, $1,000 contribution made in Shane's name to the scholarship fund at Andrean High School up in Merrillville. And let's swing across the floor if it's okay with our truck guys and pick up the PA announcement right here, right now from Scott Gregg.
And congratulations again to Shane Power and Andrean High School.
Well, now we'll get the presentation of the runner-up medallions for the Andrean Fighting 59ers. Let's go back across to Scott.
I'd like to present the runner-up medals to your 2000 Class 3A runner-up, Andrean Fighting 59ers. Making the presentation from the IHSAA Executive Committee, Sue Keenan, Lakeland High School, assisted by Dan Cunningham, Owen Valley High School. Presenting first to Matt Jensen, Andy Gernack, Shane Power, Nathaniel Staten, Josh Fry. Robbie Gard. Elliot Borden. Kevin Brown. Rashad Pace. Ryan Barbald. Justin Castellanos. Manager Willie Curran. Manager Bruce Howard. Manager Robert Falkenberg. Manager Daryl Yancey. Trainer Susan Mirovich. Trainer Andy Kirk. Assistant coach Mark Horvath. Assistant coach Kevin Brisky. Assistant coach Rodney Pace. Assistant coach Ron Frederick. And your head coach, Clint Swan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the game ball and runner-up trophy to your 2000 Class 3A runner-up, Andrean High School.
Look up there, interesting to look up there and take a look at the head coach of Andrean, Clint Swan. He's only 26. He looked like one of the players out there. Shea Powers was your Mental Attitude Award winner, and he is with Bob right now. Bob?
Shane Powers with us, and Shane, congratulations. I know a tough night for you, but winning the Mental Attitude Award is really something special. I know you have a great deal of pride about that factor tonight.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it. You know, it, like you said, it is a very special award, and only one person in a Class 3 in the state gets this, and I'm proud to represent Class 3 Indiana basketball in that way.
You guys did a tremendous job. Would have been easy to fold the tent in this ball game. The Brebeuf just had a great start, and they had it going, and you guys didn't quit. You came back in your battle, made a game of it, showed the fans that you appreciate their support.
I tell you what, hats off to Brebeuf. They came out from the start and really got into us and forced some turnovers. But, you know, we're mentally tough, so, you know, we had to fight back all game. And I think we showed some pride. I really do.
Well, you had a great season. Congratulations on your basketball playing and certainly your effort off the court. You're a special person. We congratulate you.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, Shane Power from Andrean. I tell you what, nobody loses, as Coach said earlier, and we've got some winners on both sides of the court tonight. Jerry?
Yeah. Shane finished up with 27 points and a dozen rebounds. He had a terrific game and a really nice young man. Let's go back across now to Scott and see the presentation to the Brebeuf Braves.
Ben Pitts. James Martin. Kevin McCammett. Student manager, Lance Giles. Student manager, Chris Ehringer. Student manager, Steve Shambaugh. Scorekeeper, Bill Hicks. Trainer, Joe Harvey. Assistant coach, Roosevelt Jackson. Assistant coach, Matt Shade. Assistant coach, Michael Bennett. head coach Leo Clem. Principal Sister Kathleen Baneski. And President Mrs. Ann W. King. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the game ball and championship trophy to your 2000 Class 3A state champion, Brebeuf Jesuit Braves.
Well, here is a look at the final stat story in this game tonight. What do you see jumps out at you, Dave Nicholson?
Field goal percentage, 56% for Brebeuf. Andrean, only 39%. That's the only really big difference that I see. There's a few more turnovers by Andrean, but the big deal to me, Andrean actually won the rebound battle, but Brebeuf just didn't miss very many shots. When you shoot 56%, and the other key factor, of course, is steals, and I wish we had deflections. That's hard to keep for a stat person, but they not only stole several 15 times, they deflected that many or more. And it was just too much energy, too much intensity by Brebeuf, I felt, from the get-go, and they sustained it for 32 minutes.
I don't know if you could hear on your TV set, but the Brebeuf gang behind us that Dave referred to during the game have already started the chant, No School Monday.
No School Monday.
No School Monday.
they care more about that than they did winning the trophy, the student body. But let's not be remiss and not mention Shane Power, the Mental Attitude Award winner. The folks at home got to hear him on the screen and listen to him. And you could just tell what a class person he is by the way he presented himself there. In a moment of big disappointment, completely composed, very gracious, gave the credit to Brebeuf.
I'll tell you what, Dave, we've seen three games, six teams. We've seen a bunch of young men handle themselves very, very well today.
Got to be proud of all of them. And just unusual that a championship state game would have a 16-point margin, but Brebeuf was just too strong.
All right, we've got a special break coming up here for you and then a special halftime show. Final again is Brebeuf 72 and Andrean 56 for the 3A championship.